Hey, fans of CIS basketball, welcome to SSNCanada.ca and our presentation of the University of Windsor women's basketball team taking on the Waterloo Warriors here at the St. Denis Center. Kieran here, joined by JK Jim Kennedy, and we are ready to call the action. They're just about to tip it off at center court momentarily.
Well, Tyler Slip and his Warriors are in tough tonight against the number 2 ranked team in the country, coming in with, 0 wins and all defeats. So these girls are just going to have to let it all hang out and play the best they can against this tough team on their home court.
Inside look for Clemenceau. Kicks it out to Langlois. She's going to put a three-pointer up. Rattles around, no good. Rebound Prince. She's been a terror on the boards of late. Ooh, might have got away with a travel there, Abbott. Let's just maintain possession. Langlois looking for somebody to pass to. Tried to get it inside to Clemenceau. She couldn't handle it. Prince, that is, and bobbled it out of bounds.
Raylan, fashion mogul as she is, she's got a pair of, I'm going to call them Sweet Baby Blue Nikes on tonight. So that's a different look for Raylan and the Lancers.
Into the lane now, flipping it up lefty, no good. Rebound Abbott.
That was Aaron Tilley, their leading scorer, knocking it down about 10 a game, but missed a baby bun over there and a chance for them to take the lead in this contest.
Lancers miss on their end. Raylan Prince underneath. Powers that one up.
How did that not go in?
That was halfway down.
Well, we do know that Raylan, as we reported in our special broadcast on Super Bowl Sunday, had gone to the coach. So Mike Ferretto was doing some background check on the ladies and asked the coach, how do I get on the court more? And they said, number one thing, we need you to rebound more. And she has really stepped up her game in evidence right there, getting an offensive rebound, an opportunity for a putback. Instead, she goes to the stripe for two. Started off by saying this is a game of the have and have-nots.
Yeah, no
question. As you see Bojana Kovacevic take down a rebound there. Lancers sporting that 16-2 record and the 0-18 for the Warriors.
Nice look. Kovacevic inside. Wow. Had Prince for a second. Gets her own miss again.
That's how you pad your rebound stats right there. Three rebounds for Raylan already.
Ooh, there's a lot of contact there at the elbow. Nice screen set by the Warriors, and they're able to make that wide-open jumper as a result.
Bojana went down in Saturday's contest with a shot to the chin, and then Barry...
Yeah, she's hurt.
Yeah, good call here. You know, you're going to take a lot to keep her down. I went to the replay on that after the game, and it was actually the back of Abbott's head that hit Bojana on Saturday. And here, it just looked like she caught the ankle on the screen. I think the screen was being set there by Jacobs, and she went to the ground very hard. Looks like she rattled her ribs a little bit. It'll take a lot to keep her down.
Langlois with it now. Turns the corner, picks up her dribble, finds Prince now, 16-footer, and that one's through. God. Hot start for Raylan Prince.
It is the Raylan Prince show right now, I tell you. Good gracious.
Tilley now has it for the Warriors, topside. Hands up to Hickey.
5 points
gets
for Prince.
There, top side. Picks up her dribble now. Working around are the Warriors. Inside look now. On the dribble drive. Who's that, Leach? That's Lee, sorry.
Yeah.
She'll pick up a foul and step to the line.
Tori Lee's just a sophomore. She's averaging about 5'2 a game. And, again, most of these points will be at a premium for the Waterloo Warriors this evening, as is quite the discrepancy on the stat sheet, if you will, as the Lancers average 76 a game and the Warriors average 48. So it's going to be a battle of primary possessions for the Warriors here, and they make good on those. So nice work by Lee to knock down two from the charity stripe.
5-4 is your score. 8 minutes left to play here in the first quarter. Just underway here at the St. Denis Center. A cold night in Windsor. Kicked out now. Langlois inside look for Clemenceau. Off the window. Rattles around. No good. Clemenceau picks up her own rebound, though. We're going to get a foul called on the floor. I think we're going to get Teresa Jacobs with a reach-in foul.
Laurier is definitely overmatched on the boards as the Lancers feature the tallest team in the OUA and the CIS. They're starting Prince at 6'3", and Clemenceau at about 6'3", and a lazy pass by Abbott as Clemenceau had Jacobs pinned on the baseline. Need to zip that ball in there. Lancers need to execute in a game like this. They're going to look for quality, not quantity, And so far, the quality has not been there.
Prince now has it. Looks inside for Clemenceau. Puts it down one time. Lynch is working around now. That's not a good pass. And Kovacevic almost turned it over.
Well, a tail of the pass is there. The lazy from the inbounds. And look at Abbott's going right over to Kovacevic and saying, my fault. And that pass was off target as well. But it was zipped in there. So Lancers need to settle it down. They're only leading 5-4, but early in the contest.
We're going to get a violation there. Kovacevic moved. That's a stationary throw in. And she moved a bit to her right to avoid the defender. And she was called for the violation. That's a good call, actually.
Harsh but fair. I believe that was Gary Schauer made that call. And, with Barry Amlin. Or sorry, Barry Cullen.
That's a good way to describe Barry, actually.
Yeah.
Three-pointer now on the way for the Warriors. No good. Rebound Abbott. Almost had her pocket pick. Gets it to Langlois now. She'll push into the front court. Her pass was tipped as well. She gets it back now. Prince in the high post. Across to Abbott. Gets a screen there from Clemenceau. She's going to turn and get it into the lane. Pulls up for a little baby jumper, and that one's through.
Emily Abbott, the Lionheart. Fourth-year guard out of Calgary, Alberta. Does a nice job of penetrating to the lane with the shot clock running down.
6:44 left, 7-4 lead for the Lancers in the first quarter here.
They're in their standard man-to-man defense, which they'll be in primarily for the whole contest.
Skipped across now, Tilly. Inside to Martina. Lancers come out of the pack with it. Langlois.
Nice block shot by Clemenceau. She leads the team in block shots. Is number one in the OUA and number four in the country in block shots and scoring. But you see the silly turnover there, unnecessary for the Warriors.
Substitutions now for the Lancers. Peklova comes in, as does Carissa Williams, exiting our Prince and Abbott.
This is the normal rotation, the slight change from when Peklova came back into the lineup. She was sick in the early part of the year. She had earned herself a starting spot, has stepped off performance-wise a bit, or we'll give credit to Prince for stepping it up, but Eva is the first off the bench along with Carissa Williams. You see the patented big-to-big pass by the Lancers. High to low post.
Clemenceau finishing with the left. Nice pass to a cutting Tilly. She blows the bunny, though. Lancers come back with it now.
Lancers can be stymieing on defense. They were tough against McMaster here on Sunday.
Williams has a baseline. She's going to try to reverse it off the window and good.
There's your classic Mike and drills. Underneath the basket, use it as protection.
Behind her back goes Hickey. Kicks it out now. Baseline drive well defended by Peklova there. Good job moving her feet. Again, and I think that's another block shot.
Yeah, I think we'll credit that as a block shot. Carissa Williams got caught with her head turned and a nice drive to the basket by the Warriors. She gets now the ball in the open court.
Williams kicks. Lancers working around. Clemenceau now to Kovacevic. Gets a Clemenceau on screen. Clemenceau gets it back on the roll. Turns back to her right and off the window and good. Nice, strong move by Jessica Clemenceau.
After an opening miss and some trouble on Sunday here, Clemenceau looks like she's settled in. 2-for-3 on shooting now. Halfway through the first quarter, 13-4 for the Lancers.
Just under 5 to play here in the first, as J.K. mentioned. Holding it at the top. Shot clock's winding down. Warriors got to do something, and they do find Torrey Lee on the backdoor cut.
Yeah, I think it's Tilly that's going to go to the line. As we mentioned, she's their leading scorer, this sophomore guard. Nice work there.
That is Tilly, you're right.
Lancers fall asleep at the outset here of this first quarter defensively.
And we have a timeout here at the 4:38 mark of the first quarter. When we come back, the Warriors will shoot one free throw. JK, this might be a good time for us to put the email address out there. If you want to message us via your email, we'd be very happy to hear from you. Let us know where you're at and some of your thoughts on maybe the Lancers season so far and what your perceptions are about the game here tonight. Our email address is ssnwindsor hotmail.com.
And Kieran, it wouldn't be an official broadcast unless we heard from the Holy Land as Yayan Reddy, our consummate coach from afar. He spent some time with the Lancers and Coach Ballet on their bench 3 years ago, and he's one of our faithful listeners out there. He
Absolutely.
Already says that he thinks it's going to be an evening that the whole Lancer team should be able to play if the teams play to their paper stats. And that's a good thing because you want to get all 12 players involved
sure.
here. And so we've heard from the Holy Land. We'd love to hear from wherever you're viewing the game from. Just switch to an open browser and write us at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. We'll give you a shout out. We'd love to hear from you where you're writing us from and who you're rooting for.
So stepping to the line, Aaron Tilley. Free throws off. Ball got batted around. We're getting a. Referee needed a little bit of help on that call. They decided to keep it here on the Waterloo side of the court.
The Warriors are yet to make a foul shot here in this contest. More substitutions.
Sabrina Brathwaite comes in for the Warriors, as does number 21, Heather Angus, for
Again,
the Lancers.
Regular rotation, so nothing changed for the Lancers. They're playing this as a big game. You see Puklova knocking away.
Good closeout there by Angus to force the miss.
Expect to see Morgan Jean come in for one of the guards. So Coach Ballet is treating this as primetime game time.
Nice backdoor look. Abbott couldn't make the 10-footer. She chases down her own rebound. Gets it back now. Langlois cutting through. That was there for a second. Clemenceau has it now. Top. Back to Langlois. It's a screen from Clemenceau. Top side now for Peklova. Shot clock inside 10. Nice look inside for Clemenceau.
Yeah.
Gets some contact there. Had the good seal going and finishes nicely with the left hand.
I think Kuntz is going to get called for her first foul of the contest. She is the tallest of the Warriors here this evening. She only goes at 6 foot tall. So, again, we did mention that the Warriors will be in it tough this evening with the much taller and, I'm going to say, physically quicker Lancer team as they're stretch their lead to 10 points at 16-6.
Kate Kuntz also in her first year as well. She might be in for a long night if she's going to try to check Peklova, who's, quite frankly, an MVP candidate for the OUA.
Peklova?
Or, sorry, Clemenceau.
Clemenceau.
Yeah. Did I say Peklova?
Excuse me. That's okay. Yeah, I just want to make sure. I know you're testing me, Karen.
I certainly am. Langlois,
by
the way. With the nice layup there on the other end, and Waterloo comes right back, turns the basketball over. Lancers have the ball back now with an 18-6 lead at the 3:30 mark of the first quarter.
So far for the Warriors, the pattern has been one and done, and Lancers are taking advantage.
Langlois from 14, rattles around, no good. Rebound, Warriors.
But Clova with a nice takedown move, scoring points on the UFC takedown. Got tangled up with Kuntz, I think, there, and both of them toppled to the ground.
Burnett.
Well, as predicted, Morgan Jean ready to come into the game.
Lancers with the turnover, get it inside to Peklova. Close to stepping out there. Clemenceau now from the high post on the dribble drive, flips it up lefty, and that one's through. Clemenceau racking up the points here against the Warriors tonight.
I think she knows she's not going to play many minutes.
Yeah, that's right. Going to get him early to keep that average up. She's second leading scorer in the OUA. Brathwaite now, she'll try it from three, and that one's pure as the driven snow. Angus trapped there in the backcourt right along the baseline, gets it to Langlois, and she's going to pick up a foul there.
Exactly what Coach Valle does not want to see, her number one point guard going to the ground hard.
No. And Lancers do have substitutions. See if she does take Langlois out. It looks like she is coming out reluctantly, but Angus out as well, as is Abbott. As JK indicated, Morgan Jean, she's going to get called for a traveling violation there. Nice trap there from the Waterloo Warriors. Carissa Williams also in the basketball game, and Kovacevic checks back in for the Lancers as well.
The Warriors will take this as a possession-by-possession game, not really going to pay attention to the scoreboard. They're looking to execute and get some quality play out of each possession.
Brathwaite with it. Nice inside look there for the Warriors. Try with the lefty hook off the window. No good for Megan Martina.
The rebound for Clemenceau. She is 10th in rebounding in the nation at 8.6, and she's actually 5th in the nation in scoring. She with her performance on Saturday and Sunday, bumped up her average to 19 points a game and is now number 1 in Ontario and number, as I said, 5 in the country in scoring at 19 points a game.
Lancers were called for an offensive foul, I believe, there on an illegal screen, so we'll give it back to the Warriors. Brathwaite with it now. She'll step back for three. No good. Long rebound to Waterloo.
Looks like a 2-3 zone now. Lancers, Coach Valet mixing it up in the final 2 minutes of this first quarter.
Kuntz,
there's
now
a tough move. Paklova all over it. Wow. Kuntz can't make that. Over 6'5", Czech Republic native, okay. Ava Paklova.
Inside for Clemenceau, up lefty, and that one looked a little bit too easy for, I'm sure,
well, that's
Coach Slip's liking.
That's 8 or 10 for Clemenceau. As I see Jessica Gordon coming off the bench, I bet she's coming in for Gordon. Clemenceau's already got 10 points.
Yeah. Baseline now. Kuntz with it. Back to topside, Brathwaite. Warriors work it inside. Finally, Martina. No good. Rebound.
Excellent defense Kovacevic on the weak side by Paklova coming across on the zone to challenge the shot.
Jean to Williams. Inside now for Paklova. Inside pivot. Skips it across. Kovacevic. Now Jean has it. Three-pointer on the way. Off the heel. No good. Kovacevic hustling after that rebound.
As she always does. Yep. You know, Kieran, I'm just going to challenge you on your call there. One of my issues with Ava is she actually tends to pivot outside.
Okay.
When she gets ball at post, whereas you see Clemenceau, she drop steps or pivots inside 90% of the time. And Ava has missed scoring opportunities at 6'5" by constantly pivoting to the outside, giving the defense a chance to challenge her and not putting herself into a scoring position. We'll watch her footwork here down the stretch.
Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound. Waterloo, another long rebound.
Boy, unlucky there.
Try it off the window. Looked like it wanted to go down.
Wayne Moore is liking this, the final
seconds. He sure is. Kovacevic, I think they're going to call her for a travel, and that's exactly the call there.
That's two travel calls on Boyana. That's her first one on the actual court, though. The other one being on the inbounds play. She traveled while inbounding the ball.
And that's going to do it for the first quarter of this contest here. The Lancers have a nice 13-point lead, 22-9 over the Waterloo Warriors. JK, pretty good first quarter, I guess, for the Lancers. Coach Valet must be pleased. Interesting, before the game started, we were talking about how the Lancers may approach this one. The standings speak for themselves, the 0-18 versus 16-2. We thought that the Lancers may take this game as an opportunity to give some of their bench some playing, some opportunities to play. Coach Valet's approached this as a business as usual.
She has, and I think the word here is execution. Add to that word would be quality. Yeah. And you want to create an atmosphere where you don't want to change what you've done consistently to this point. So it's not a game that we're going to take off. We don't want them to overlook somebody to get to the next opponent, because when you get to the championships, which the Lancers are on target for doing so, whether it's the OUA championship, whether it's the bronze baby to be contested right here at the University of Windsor, which is the trophy for the women's national championship, you want to have that consistency right through every game that you play.
And we're just having an opportunity now to look at the stat sheet, JK. I wouldn't mind hearing some of Raylan Prince's line, actually. We know she was a terror on the boards in the early going, and Clemenceau racked up a few herself, I think.
4 early rebounds for Raylan, and topped by her points at 5. Leading scorer for the Lancers at shooting 5 for 6, and all of those were bunny is, of course, Jessica Clemenceau. She has 11 points because she knocked down one of her foul shots as well. So, again, the consistency from the Lancers. They're shooting 58%, holding the visiting Warriors to 20%. Let's just say they're not very good hosts.
No. Looks like the Warriors are going to begin the second quarter with Braithwaite, number nine, Tilly, Lee. Who do we have here? 22 is Martina, as well as number 13, Teresa Jacobs.
Lancers will switch back to their man-to-man. Prince and Gordon down in the post. I like to see that long lineup with Kovacevic.
Abbott and Jean, nice block there by Kovacevic. She stepped out.
What?
She couldn't keep it alive? She couldn't. She had to step out of bounds?
Yeah.
Easy drive by Braithwaite, and I give her credit for challenging the bigs of Windsor. Not exactly an advised policy, but she did take them on. And Boyana sent it back but stepped out of bounds.
Tough defense there inside by the Lancers on that inbounds. Forced the Waterloo to change what they were trying to get done there. Shot clock winding down inside 5 seconds. Wild shot.
See, now that's a bailout call.
Out.
Yeah, that's a call that it is a foul. I mean, I can't deny that it is a foul, but it was a slight one at best.
Mm-hmm.
And Morgan Jean actually bailed the shooter out.
Mm-hmm.
It was a foul, so we're going to stick with that. But Morgan, she had no reason to foul in that situation, having, I believe it was a Tilly in this case, going hard to her left. And it's costly as she hits the bottom of the well. So Morgan just needs to cut off that lane. Jean has been an excellent find for the Lancers.
Sure
as
has.
You mentioned, they had their injury and illness
yep.
issues in the first half of the season where they played the Eastern Conference teams. And Morgan was not even going to play,
mm-hmm.
having transferred from Guelph University. And, well, when Coach Vallée got Heather Angus into the lineup, Heather said, you know, I got my point guard here at the Faculty of Education.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to give her a chat. And she's really played herself into playing shape and into fine playing time, averaging 5.5 a game and several good quality minutes.
Well, I think she had 16 the other night against Guelph.
Sure did, her alma mater.
Kovacevic now for three, and that one right through the ring.
Boy, you talk about hitters getting it in their wheelhouse.
Yeah.
That was a perfect pass from Abbott to Kovacevic. Didn't even hesitate. Nyar knocked it down from three.
Hickey now has it. She'll try to drive it on Jean. Cut off nicely there. Forced to kick it out. Hickey will get it back. Topside. Working it around now. That's going to be a traveling violation.
Yep. There's that classic look that athletes have. They look to the basket and then hop before they dribble the ball. I'd rather see a sweep and a pivot, because then you can establish that foot, and the referees will typically let it go if the foot is dragged. But there was a clear hop before she dribbled.
Jean now inside to Gordon. High post. Ill-advised pass there. Good job getting back in transition by all of the Lancers, frankly.
Turnover has got to be answered with something positive. Look for Gordon to get a rebound or a block shot.
Nice hard take there by Aaron Tilly all the way to the hole, not able to finish, and right back at it are the Lancers. And Kovacevic blows the layup. You don't see that often, but cleaning up that mess.
Five rebounds, seven points for Prince.
27-11 now. The Lancers have pushed the lead to 16, 8-14 left here in the half. Three-pointer now on the way topside for Megan Martina. That one's through.
Nice job by Martina. She only shoots it at, not a bad clip there, 37% from three-point range. But goodness gracious, that was a long way out. First three for the Warriors.
Prince now giving Abbott the screen. She's
going
to take it all the way. What happened to the Waterloo defense there?
I think Abbott didn't realize how open she was.
Yeah.
Monster screen by Prince.
Three-pointer on the way for Kovacevic, rattling around, no good. Lancers still working to get that rebound. Waterloo eventually comes up with it. Lead pass now. Hard take baseline. Well defended there by Jean against number 15, Sarah Hickey. Or
good
Saraya
cleaning
Hickey.
Cleaning a glass by Jessica Gordon. Had an excellent game against Laurier on Saturday.
Hard take there by Boyana Kovacevic on the right side. Wasn't able to finish. Got all the way to the rim. Looked open there for a second, but fouled, and she'll step to the line for two free throws.
Help out there was by Tilly coming down from the post. It was a little bit late. Tilly is carrying a heavy load for the Warriors this year. As we mentioned, they've had a tough year for Coach Tyler, and looking in his third year just to kind of get things to kind of just hold the ship, if you will, and then right it next year with some new incoming recruits and let these girls develop as they go through a rather tough season.
Well, if you, I mean, you look at the Waterloo Warrior roster right now, and I see 9 players in their first year. Only one fourth-year player. This is a team that's certainly feeling some growing pains this year, and expect them to be much improved next year. Lancer's showing some pressure here. Full court. Waterloo breaks it. Aaron Tilley has it now for the Warriors. He's going to try to turn the corner. Flips it up lefty. No good. Rebound by Glova. Langlois has it now. Beglova gets it back. Jean with it. High post now to Prince.
There's the sweep and drive.
Yeah. Off the window, no good. Rebound, Peklova. She has it stripped.
Yeah, but she brought it down. She never should have brought it down to the waist where the tiny, mighty moles can get it.
That's exactly right, JK. Good call. Crossover now. Who's that, Tilly? No. Oh, and that one's blocked by Raylynn Prince
filling up the stat sheet
she
there.
She is filling up the stat sheet. Boards, blocks, and points. Inside look, Peklova. Nice pass. Kicked it out. Carissa Williams did. Topside now. Langlois has it. She's going to get a Raylynn Prince screen. Shot clock winding down. 5 seconds now to shoot. Another inside look to Peklova. That wasn't there.
Yeah, that late in the shot clock, Raylynn has got to shoot it. Nice offense by the Lancers, though. They all touch the ball, which is great when you see the rotation and the sharing of the ball. This team trusts each other.
Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound Peklova. Lancers have substitutions coming in.
One and done, and no energy from the Warriors either. Not even attempting to send somebody to the offensive glass where so much of good things can happen on just pure hustle.
Lance is working around Jean. Now she'll try it from three, and that one's through.
The diminutive one, 5'5", knocking it down from 25.
31-14 is the score. Lancers more than doubling up on the Warriors now. 5:26 left here in the first. Jean's going to tie her up. No call, so just give it back to the Lancers. Play on here. Langlois has it. Gets it to Prince, topside. Inside look for Carissa Williams. What a pass.
I think she was ready for it.
Tried to reverse there.
Wonderful pass from Raylynn.
Couldn't finish on the layup. Peklova actually did come down with the rebound for a moment, but was so far underneath the basket, actually stepped out of bounds.
Just a little aside there as you see Raylynn go to the bench with 5 rebounds and 7 points. She just looked over at Carissa and tapped her chin, giving her the signal, keep your head up. I'm going to find you in there. A nice little encouragement by Raylynn to remind Carissa, you're not just running a pattern. You've got to keep your eye open. We're going to look for you in there.
Aaron pass there for the Warriors. No deflection either. That's just going to be Lancer ball back in the front court. New substitution, Amber Irvine in for the Lancers.
Elmer native, having seen some good quality minutes over the last three games, all of them in a homestand for the Lancers.
Clemenceau
end of January, February homestand.
And she's going to try it right away. Elbow jumper, no good. Rebound, Warriors. Burnett had to chase it down. She gets it back now on the wing. Inside look. Going to get a kick. Kicking violation called against the Lancers. Shot clock will remain at 14 seconds.
Coach Tyler Slip has really gone to two ends of the extreme, having spent some time as the number one assist for the Simon Fraser Clanswomen. Okay. When they won the national championship, their run of 5 or 6 in a row, he was on the bench out there, but took the opportunity 3 years ago to come to Waterloo. Has been at the helm for 3 years and spent some time with the Canadian National Development Program as well. So in tough here with his Lady Warriors.
Peklova, jumper no good. Rebound, Warriors pushing now into the front court. Burnett picks up her dribble. Martina thought about the three.
Lancers are just so good positionally on defense. The Warriors are having tough executing any sort of offense.
On the dribble drive, Burnett not able to convert with the right hand there. Little floater. Oh, maintain possession on the out of bounds. However, fresh shot clock for Waterloo. Nice cut inside. Oh, blew the layup. Disappointing
for
Aaron Tilly.
And then got body checked out of the way by Carissa Williams on that box out. Paklova having trouble in the post again and then gets caught with the extra dribble. You could see maybe the pass by Carissa was just a little bit early before Paklova got settled in the post and so much. Well, here's something great. I'm going to switch off my Paklova comments and really glad to see Jocelyn the Rock into the game. We called the game on Saturday, and Jocelyn had tweaked her knee. She's had nothing but knee injuries and problems this year. She tweaked her knee and was out of the contest against Laurier, and on Sunday ended up not playing for the same reason, just injury issues. So good to see her early in the contest and in from the St. Anne's High School Saints. Chance for Jocelyn to get going here today.
She gets in the book right away, I think, picking up a foul right there. No, they're going to give it to Irvine. The Rock was reaching in, though, so trying to get into the stat sheet. Oh, nice look inside, and Martina knows what to do with it. Scores over Raylan Prince there. Langlois in the open floor, finds Prince cutting. She loses the handle.
Just catch it, Raylan, just catch it.
Long deuce on the way. Rims out for the Lancers. Brathwaite now with it for Waterloo. Being harassed by Mia, you know what she's thinking.
Yeah, Maya Langlois is one of the top defenders in the nation. She is 11th in steals nationally right now, so she could pick a pocket or two.
Oh, nice block that there was by Raylan Prince, but we're going to get a foul called.
Yep, much closer to the action than we are,
sure.
But that sure looked clean from 700 feet away.
It looked clean from from our vantage point, no question. That's the Lancers' third team foul. 31-16 is the score here with 2:44 left to play in the half. First free throw on the way, and that one's off the front of the rim. Madison Bear.
Maddie Bear, another one of those freshmen we just mentioned earlier, Kieran. And, you know, good observation on your part. I hadn't realized the amount of freshmen and the lack of seniors. One senior on this Warriors team, and that makes it tough for any club to be successful in the OUA level.
Second one's through, 31-17 now. Langlois, she turns the corner. What are we going to do with the possession? Okay. Tapped out of bounds. Lancers will maintain possession. 10 seconds left to shoot. LaRock will trigger. Inside look for Clemenceau, and there's another one. I talked about being too easy.
13 points. Boy, you knew that was coming.
Yeah.
Right from the get-go, and that was Jocelyn LaRock gets the assist there. Just too easy inside for the Lancers.
Jumper no good for the Waterloo Warriors.
7 rebounds for Prince. And that's in a little under a half a play.
Inside look for Clemenceau. She gets tapped there. Forced the bobble there on the foul. That call had to come. Substitutions for the Lancers now. Abbott, Kovacevic, and Angus getting ready to check in. Irvine, Prince, and LaRock will
And they may just be keeping Jocelyn on a short clock in terms of playing. That knee is heavily bandaged right now, although she looked a little despondent coming out that early in the contest. She was only in there for about 2 minutes.
Kicked out now for Abbott. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound Waterloo. Braithwaite comes out of the pack. Tries to throw the lead pass, and that's tapped by the Lancers. They come back with it now. Abbott's caught from behind.
Caught from behind and had Kovacevic streaking down the right wing, and I think she was going to go there. So give credit to the Warriors for coming back. Good attempt at that, but called on the foul. I believe that was on Burnett.
Hickey and Lee check into the basketball game for the Warriors. Langlois now from 17, and that one's right through the center of the ring.
Well, we've had 22 players play in this contest already. They're going to keep us tested here with the names, Kieran, as all 10 have played for the Warriors and all 12 have played for the Lancers.
out of bounds. The ball was thrown directly out of bounds. No touch there by any player on the court, so we'll throw it in at the original throw-in location.
Deep into the second quarter, 1:19 left, and still no real foul challenges from either team as they're tied at 3-3 in fouls. Mm-hmm. So this game has flowed along rather quickly. We're at 6:36, and we're coming to the end of the first half.
Kovacevic gets it back topside. Across now to Angus. They're trying to look. They're looking inside for Clemenceau. Finally get that in there. The double team comes, kicked out to Kovacevic. No good. Rebound Clemenceau. We're going to get a foul call.
It's a hold. Hold on the inside there. Looks like it was Jacobs. Gets called for the hold. Boy, she's got her handful.
She sure does.
Fifth leading scorer in the nation right now as Clemenceau is a constant threat inside, tapping herself her own rebound.
Another lazy pass there, almost intercepted by the Warriors on the inbounds. Clemenceau lost the handle. Kovacevic ends up with it off the window and right through.
Stepped in to take the charge, was just a step late. Yeah. Boyana actually got in the air first, and a good no call by Barry Cullen as there could have been a charge, but because she was in the air first, you have to let her come down.
Lancers come up with a steal on the other end. Back at it offensively now, Clemenceau. She'll kick it out. Abbott off one dribble, and she'll jack that one up.
Boy, the Energizer Bunny ever.
Now,
second in the team in steals to Langlois, number two in rebounding, second in scoring. The Cat does it all.
Lancers look like they're going to turn it over here. Waterloo.
Oh, Braithwaite with the moving screen.
That was definitely a moving screen. No
and Boyana was none too pleased with that.
Lancers, though, forced the miss, and they'll get a three-pointer just before the buzzer. Rattles around, no good. So at the end of the first half of play, it's the University of Windsor Lancers 37 over the Waterloo Warriors, who have 17 points after 20 minutes of play. We are going to take a short break here, 15 minutes or so. If you want to email us, by the way, I'll remind you, I would love to hear from you. Let us know where you're emailing us from and some of your thoughts on the game here tonight at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. As I mentioned, about 15 minutes away from starting here in the third quarter. So we'll be back in just a few minutes. And you've been listening to CIS Basketball on ssncanada.ca. Okay, we are ready to get back underway here for the second half of the University of Windsor women's basketball team taking on the Waterloo Warriors. The first half of our doubleheader here this evening at the St. Denis Center on a cold night in Windsor. The second half, we'll see the men's teams squaring off here. To start the second half, we have the Lancers with the opening possession.
Lancers go with their starters, so Coach Vallée wants to keep a consistent rhythm to the game and preparedness for the next few contests.
Kicked out to Kovacevic, three-pointer on the way.
You think she should have been practicing those. So Prince picks up her seventh rebound for her 7 points.
Abbott now picks up her dribble right at the foul line, had a shot there, elected to pass, tried to hit Clemenceau underneath. It was alone there, but passes a little off the mark, I guess would be the best way to describe it. And out of bounds, give it back to the Warriors. Tough screen there set by the Warriors. Top side freed up number 15, Soraya Hickey. Blew the layup, though. Lancers now back in transition. Langlois with it, finds Clemenceau underneath this time. It connects, and she's good off the window.
Well,
39-17.
We mentioned uncharacteristic for Jessica on both Saturday and Sunday, their back-to-back games. Mm-hmm. Didn't have a great shooting performance, and she does average about 50%. Long-range three for the Warriors there.
Actually,
Jessica spent some extra time before and after practice the last couple of days just working on her touch around the basket. Boy, it's really paid off for her.
It sure has.
15 points for Jessica, leading all scorers.
Prince now. She's going to take it hard to the basket. Wow. Lay it up and in.
Oh,
nice looking move.
Ray Lynn, 9 points, 7 rebounds. She has just stepped up her game so much, taking advantage of the Warriors.
I think she might have a block in there too, JK. Oh, that's a travel.
Yeah, and they couldn't let that one go. Our three-man rotation of Gary Schauer, Barry Cullen, and Gord Clifford. Gord caught that one. Easy call as she stepped inside the three-point line.
Lancers have it back now. Langlois with it. Kovacevic directing traffic. Picks up her dribble. Skips across now for Abbott. Gets a Clemenceau on screen. Goes the other way. Baseline now. Almost lost her dribble. Kicks it out now. Prince baseline. Top for Langlois. Long three on the way. Off the front. No good. Rebound Kovacevic.
Dirty rebound in a crowd. People all around. She brings it down.
And a nice look inside for Clemenceau. Cutting to the window.
Boy, they're firing on all cylinders here.
43-20 now. Lancers with the 23-point advantage over the Warriors. 7:50 left to play here in the third. Warriors just looking for a good, solid possession. Top side now. Tilly has it for the Warriors. Inside 10 to shoot. Gets it to Hickey. Nice look inside. Back to Tilly. Blew the layup again, though. The number of blown layup opportunities. Langlois now will try it from 15. Another rebound for Kovacevic, and she finishes off
the
window.
She's just everywhere, and I got to throw this out there. My wife, Lorraine Kennedy, who spends most of the time coaching our kids when she's at their games, and she says all she wants them to do is to watch Kovacevic. She's everywhere and always on top of the ball. And, boy, that kid, she just gets after it. There she is again.
And there she is
with
again.
Her steal.
Pulling away with the basketball.
Boy, right on cue.
Yeah.
Not only that, she has an extremely extraordinary great sense of timing.
Yeah.
I mean, for me to talk about her, she makes the steal.
She must have heard you. Great hearing, too, probably.
I know she's one of Coach Reddy's favorite players. He wrote us again from the Holy Land. Glad to hear from Jerusalem and Coach Reddy. You mentioned a couple of interesting points at how hard Ray Lynn has worked, and one of the original recruits for Coach Vallée, the only fifth-year player on the Lancers. And, of course, Laura Mullins is on the bench but has not played because of injury, is actually looking to come back after double ACL surgery this year.
Wow.
So, you know,
that's commitment.
There's someone who just loves the game. And, you know, most of them will say, let's cash it in this year. Let's focus on next year. She wants to play now, and I think a big part of it is the Lancers are hosting, ladies and gentlemen, the Women's National Championship in March here, contesting for the bronze, baby.
Lancers have gone on a bit of a tear in the last few minutes or so, and they're going to step to the line to add with an opportunity to add to their lead. 47-22 is the score at the 6:28 mark. Clemenceau will step to the line. First one's through.
We did mention that the Lancers dominated the first half statistics
But did drop off of their shooting to 47%. I'm a little disappointed in the ladies.
I'm sure Coach Valet will have them running running suicides next.
But at the same point, they held the Warriors to 17% in that first half, and Warriors have come out and scored five here. Mm-hmm. Lancers have scored 12.
Whoa, ankle-breaking move there by the Warriors.
Either that or the paint on that line is a little bit thick, and Boyana didn't recognize it.
Kovacevic right back, though. Kicks it out to Carissa Williams, who's checked into the basketball game. Inside look now for Clemasso. Nice. Well defended there by Martina.
But Jessica's got to get that shot off. I mean, Martina just simply stood there with her hands up, Martina, and did a nice job of acknowledging the fact that she had inside presence, Jessica did, and there was not even a shot made.
Lancers almost got the five-second call there. Hickey has it now, though, for the Warriors. 6:03 left to play, 49-22. Lancers up big. Hickey will try it from three, no rim. Bounces out of bounds, give it back to Windsor. Substitutions, Jean and Kuntz in for the Warriors and the Lancers, respectively.
I like this lineup. It's a different group out there with Morgan Jean going to handle the ball, which pushes Maya to the off guard or shooting guard and Carissa Williams to the three. Well, there's the reason why.
Look at this backdoor cut.
Great
blows
pass.
The layup, but she can't believe it a little bit.
Might be the best quality that Poklova has is her ability to pass.
And look at Langley's hobbling a little bit. I'm sure that's we talked about that earlier. Nice pass, though, in the open floor. Clemenceau gets it right back. No call there, but just doesn't matter.
Well,
I
was harsh on her in a last evaluation where she didn't get the shot off that one. Yeah. She had Martine hanging on her, and she made the shot. So maybe they just need to make it really tough for Jessica, and she'll make them. She's talking down there, too. She wanted the call.
Mm-hmm. Long deuce there on the way. Ill-advised.
Well, Jessica's well on her way to a double-double here in points and rebounds.
Jean has it. We have a substitution getting ready to come in. Amber Irvine, I'm going to bet that she's going to take Langlois out, who's actually kneeling down.
Yeah, there's...
She was hobbling after she missed that layup. She stayed on the floor for a moment and, you know, picked herself up off the floor.
Do you think it's a hip? Because she kind of got knocked after she attempted the layup.
I think it's definitely lower body, JK, and I think that goes back to the original...
hockey injury.
Yeah,
oh, sorry, right. Lower body.
But I think that goes back to the fall that she had in the first half.
Very good observation, Kieran, and I think the Lancers do not want to see that happening.
Wow. Morgan Jean, I think that is what they want to see happening, though. But then coming right back is number 13, Teresa Jacobs. Just beats everybody back down the floor and lays it up and in. But, wow, I didn't think Jean could shoot the basketball like that. Peklova.
Need to use the backboard. The backboard is your friend. Poklova has really struggled mightily here, if we could say that, in the last few games. But thank goodness her teammates have been there to pick her up. She doesn't need to be an all-world player nor scorer with the support of Clemenceau inside and, of course, the way Raylin has stepped up her game. But, you know, you still want to see her have confidence when she goes to the basket, and then she lacked it there. Really not a confident stroke towards the basket.
You know, I would definitely agree with you, JK. It's funny, though. You watch Peklova play. The other aspects of her game are still there. She moves the ball well. She plays smart basketball. Her defense and rebounding hasn't dropped off, I would say, significantly given the minutes that she's playing.
As you see her come up with the loose ball there, good work by Ava there, and Jean poked it away.
Clemenceau trying to find a shot, finds Peklova, see if she shoots that one confidently, and that one nestles its way through.
Well, she was actually backing out. She was going to be called for three in the key, and Clemenceau found her there. So big-to-big passing again. It's working for the Lancers.
56-24, 3:41 left here in the third. Braithwaite has it now. It's at baseline for Kuntz. Working around nicely are the Warriors, finding a nice shot there inside for Teresa Jacobs. Jean now back for Windsor. Dribbles through a crowd. Carissa Williams now has a topside over to Clemenceau. She's going to take it hard. Flips it up lefty. Count that one.
There's a written scouting report.
Yeah.
There's video evidence.
That's right.
And most of the CIS knows you must take away Clemenceau's left. It's unusual. She's a right-handed player.
Yep.
But she's so good to the left. You've got to. She went from 20 feet from the basket. She was at the three-point line when she caught that and drove right to the tin.
Yep. No question. Not to mention she's been beating you left all day, too.
Wow.
And the free throw is good. She'll come out of the basketball game.
Averaging 89% from the foul line. Yeah. She's so consistent there. Bottoms out on that one.
Lancers actually lead the OUA in free throw shooting. Coming into play this evening. Raylan Prince checks in for Clemenceau. But we're going to have it back to the Sarah Leach with the errant pass. Turns the ball over. Give it back to Windsor.
Let's see if the twosome of Prince and Gordon can work as Clemenceau and Paklova do big-to-big passing.
Gene gets a Gordon screen.
Or we could have the 5'5" kid take it right to the tin. Morgan Gene has 8 points, two threes, and a deuce.
I think she's going to see a lot of PT. And looking at the bench now, they're retaping Langlois's ankle, it looks like.
Oh, interesting.
Her leg.
She does not need to play anymore.
No, I would agree with you there, JK.
And I wouldn't mind seeing LaRocque play.
Absolutely.
Jocelyn needs some playing time.
Raylan Prince.
Jumper.
Can't believe that didn't go through, but Gordon cleans that
one
up.
In a way, that's big-to-big passing, isn't it?
Yeah, to some degree, yeah. Just throw it up on the rim. You see your 6'6" center underneath. Doesn't matter if I make or miss.
Offensive rebounds. It's about heart and hustle. Nice job by Jessica to go get that.
63-26. Lancers getting it done here, particularly in the third quarter. Waterloo, three-pointer, no good. Rebound is reeled in by Heather Angus. Trapped there, just over half court. Gene has it. Inside look for Prince. Baseline move, no good. Rebound, Waterloo. They almost turn it over. Coming out of the pack now with it is Burnett. Aaron shot there from Sarah Leach. Lancers get it back. Angus inside look there for Raylan Prince. She's doubled immediately. She's going to have to get out of there. Good job. Under 10 seconds to shoot. Back to Prince. Again with the double team. She's tied up. I don't know if that pass was such a good idea.
No, with the shot clock running down, it's not bad to dump it into the post. But Raylan had not reposted. And I'm going to attribute this very good substitution here. Oh, I thought she was going off. She's just going to go talk with Coach Valley. Raylan is really tired. There have been a stretch of about 4 or 5 trips up and down, and the bigs have to go the full 90 feet. The guards get it easy. They just go from three-point line to three-point line. But I think she was a little fatigued, and that's why she lost the ball. You don't see her get tied up too much. She's just so very, very strong with the ball.
Interesting call there. Looked like it might have gone off Jessica Gordon's leg, and I think the Waterloo Warriors thought the same thing, actually. But we'll give it back to Windsor.
Coach Tyler's slip is still sending in his legions, still so making them work.
Gordon now on the turnaround. No good. Rebound Waterloo. Substitutions ready to come back in for the Lancers, LaRocque and Peklova. I think you might be right with the call on the substitution for Raylan Prince. Braithwaite now. She's going to try to reverse off the window. Nice move there.
Gordon's got to recognize that earlier. She's been working on her physical fitness, on her strength and conditioning with Coach Frank Jenny, who's done just a super job here at the university with all the programs. Interesting that Frank makes comment about this particular team that he does not have to monitor. He does not need to take attendance of all the teams here at the University of Windsor, where they will monitor how long they're in the room. These girls measure and monitor themselves. The team he least has to worry about, they work out so very, very hard, and Jessica has worked on that. That was just a timing issue watching Braithwaite go to the 10.
And go figure, they've been ranked number one in the country most of the season and are ranked number two currently.
Final 30 seconds here of the third quarter.
Angus, nice move, taking it to the basket on the left side. Draws some contact, and she'll get free throws.
Heather Angus from Hamilton, played at Guelph for 3 years, and like Morgan Jean, is here to attend Teachers College, focusing on her academics. Glad to have her in the lineup, an experienced player. She's actually in her fifth year of eligibility. Her and Raylan Prince are the only fifth-year academic players, and she's finishing off her career with the opportunity to contest for the Bronze Baby and really enjoying herself here in the southern tip of Canada, University of Windsor.
Second one through, 65-27, 28 seconds left in the third quarter. Top side now for the Warriors. Bear with it, picks up her dribble. Braithwaite now has it. He's going to look inside. Kick back out. Braithwaite is going to try it for three. No,
yeah, Laheed was posting up there, and well advised for her to kick that ball back out.
Yeah.
McKenzie is a freshman and made a good decision there, but the Warriors couldn't take advantage of it.
Going up against a 6'6" Gordon, and Morgan Jean fearless. Peklova ends up with the basketball, and she can't finish just prior to the buzzer. So after three quarters of play, it's the University of Windsor Lancers, unsurprisingly, I hate to put it that way, but up big against the Waterloo Warriors, 65-27.
I looked that one up, unsurprisingly.
Yeah, well, and I mention it that way because I want to ask you, you know, in a game like this, you get in the huddle with, you know, your coach Tyler Slip, and, you know, they really took it on the chin there, particularly in the third quarter, did the Waterloo Warriors. And at the end of it, looked like they were running out of steam. What do you do to get your team motivated to play some basketball here?
Well, it's similar to what we said in the first half. And, you know, Tyler's been around the game long enough. We mentioned his experience with the Klansmen, where he won a national championship and assistant coach. But we should also mention that his work with the University of New Brunswick. He coached with his mother out there, who was a longstanding and very successful coach at the University of New Brunswick. And I know that Tyler will break this down, I think, in a possession-by-possession game.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to just get his girls to compete and be consistent in each 24-second possession. And again, they haven't done that very well in that third quarter, so that's what he wants to motivate, encourage, and teach them to do, because this is obviously a coaching lesson for the future with the youth of his team.
And then on the other side of things, you know, we talked about a couple of the you know, the same question I could ask you about Coach Vallée. I mean, you have a team that's up, you're up almost 40 points on a team with a quarter left to play. You know, and so what are you thinking? I mean, obviously you want to get out of this game without any further injury issues. It looks like Langlois may be done for the day, although she did, her shoes are back on and laced up, so she is available, I think. But, you know, how do you keep your Lancer team, number two team in the country, interested in this game?
Well, are you asking me what I would do or what I think Coach Vallée is going to do?
How about both?
All right, well, I'm going to go first with what I would do. My starters would have their butts on the bench right now.
Yeah.
I would not play them. It's too valuable to have them down the stretch, and that would be mine. I think Coach Vallée may give them a little look here, maybe one more shift into this fourth quarter, and then she'll turn off the faucet. She's a very competitive and a strategic coach. And I you see LaRocque is into the game here.
Well, she's listening to the broadcast, JK, because there's not a starter on the floor.
Yeah, five non-starters. And that, I think, is the right decision. Let these girls play. They earn so much of their time in practice by making everybody work so hard. Jocelyn, nice work on her own rebound. Gets it
there.
And throws it in there.
You know, we talked about the issues she's had with the injuries, but she certainly looked mobile there.
Yeah, not the first year that she thought she would have even an opportunity to contest as the starting guard because of the fact that we lost Siobhan Rini this year, who was a consummate fifth-year point guard for the Lancers. So Jocelyn would just look forward to this playing time.
Angus there, blowing the layup there. That's the second time from that same angle where she's not been able to convert on a layup at point blank range. I don't know, JK. You want to see her use the left hand there or what?
I definitely want left hand out of that, or self online by doing a 2 foot jump hop. It just seems like you're absolutely right, Karen, when you made the reference that that's two left handers in a row, but they're both running layups.
Yeah.
I wouldn't mind to see her gather herself, get a 2 foot power off, and that'll give her the confidence to make the next one.
Inside look now for Laheed.
Wow. That's, yeah.
Well, she's going to shoot free throws.
She's going to.
Yep.
Could time that move with a calendar. And Gordon just fell for it. 30-point margin right now for, sorry, did 40. I say 30? Wow.
It's 40, yeah.
40-point margin, and Lancers are on track, obviously, for their average point total, but holding the Warriors much below theirs. They only scored 27. They average 48.
Angus gets it to Gene. High post now.
Now it's sloppy.
Tie it
Lancers
up.
Lancers need to just get a little crisper. Let's still play with a little more energy. NRG into the game.
I think it was a bad angle to throw that pass there, too. Gave the defender an
opportunity.
Watch
Paklova screen across and then post. Oh, no, she popped out. There she goes. Now should posting. Boy, Gordon's wide open for a post.
High post now. Paklova has it. Picks up her dribble. Inside look for Angus. Nice on the reverse. Flips it up righty. No good. Rebound Gordon. She fills it up off the window. 69-27. 8:46.
Nice
left
work
here
by
in
Jessica
this contest.
Picking up her first two.
Don't forget to our listeners, the second half of this doubleheader. Tip off around 8 o'clock after this one is completed. 20 minutes after the completion of this game. Ball's tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Warriors.
Morgan Jean is negotiating.
Yeah.
Barry Cullen's saying, listen, you're up 42. I'm not giving you that call.
Yeah.
Love the competitive spirit.
Paklova picks up her dribble. Gets it inside to Gordon. Little jumper.
How do you stop that?
You really
can't.
One
dribble, pull-up jumper by 6'6", Jessica Gordon. Yeah. 4 points for her, 71 for the Lancers.
You look at Tori Lee, who was guarding her on that play, 5'7". She's almost giving up a full foot to Jessica Gordon on that.
Lahey, rebound inside. Yeah. Nice job by her. A dirty rebound in a crowd.
She's giving them some good minutes here, Lahey has. And on the dribble drive, righty flip, no good. Rebound, Paklova.
Right decision by the Warriors there, as you saw Bear go to the basket.
And Morgan Jean's going to take it all the way to the basket. Are they going to get that one
and
on
there? I
was
just making reference to the right decision as Bear squared up and swept, which means she takes the ball from high to low. We call it chin to toe. And she saw that Paklova came out, and we call it giving her the knee. Instead of coming out flat on defense, which means you give no options left or right, she showed her left knee, and a good offensive player will attack the knee. And that's exactly what Bear did and took it to her strength right to the 10. It didn't pay off, but it was the right decision to make. Good aggressive offensive move.
Great analysis there, JK. 72-27. Another free throw to come. Rattling around. That's going to be... Whoa. Looked like it went off of Paklova, but... Again, we don't have the good angle.
Straight box set. Paklova, she shouldn't be bouncing around in the key here. She should go straight across screen for Gordon, then post. Nah, she just wants the ball.
Yeah. Sets the screen. Angus
set
has
play.
It now.
LaRoc comes, should fire it. There we go.
Deep
beautiful.
Three on the way. Well off. Lancers are able
give
to
her another one.
Gather that rebound. Shot clock. No reset on the shot clock there.
Because she didn't hit much.
Under 10 seconds to shoot. LaRoc has it tipped away. She'll skip it across for Morgan Jean. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Jean hustling after it.
Oh, she just hopped out of bounds. Right idea. She turned and whipped it off of Tilly's leg, but had stepped just out of bounds. As you saw referee Gordon Clifford make that call. Tad closer than we are, as we are 8,000 feet above the St. Denis Center here. The SSN booth. our producer, Mike Ferrato, says to me he's working on it. Hopefully by the CIS National Championships, we'll be on the floor, Karen.
We can only dream, JK. We can only dream.
I live to dream. That's right.
LaRoc with the steal. And she's going to flip it up off the window. Nice, easy layup there for LaRoc.
4 points for LaRoc. And the number one fan on the bench is Jessica Clemenzo. She's got 24, and LaRoc's got four, but Jessica's clapping as if it was her own self scoring those baskets. Nice work.
Tilly has it now for the Warriors.
I bet the five on the floor are wondering, who is Amber Irving coming in for? I want to play.
And there's a three-pointer that goes through for the Warriors.
Tori Lee
with the
long
three.
Range.
That was a deep three, no question about it. 74-30.
Whoa.
Oh, looking inside there.
That's a turnover. You better come in for Angus. She turned the ball
over. Yeah, that might be it, too. I think you mentioned, you talked about
that. There it is. There it is. You make a mistake. Oh, no, it's
Jessica Gordon. I remember in the last game that we did together, JK, you talked about Irving and Angus as almost interchangeable players.
Yeah.
I think you're spot on with that.
Other than the fact that one's a fifth year, one's a first year, yeah. but nice drive right to the tin. Good job by Bear. That's twice she's gone to her power hand with a chin-to-toe sweep. Nice work by her. And I mean by chin-to-toe, catch the ball high, sweep to low, and drive to the basket.
Oh. Again, on that left side, Angus. Or sorry, that was, now I'm getting confused. That was Irvine with it.
Yeah, just got your Mertzwicks there, but we meant what you knew, Karen. There's no bow to doubt it. The man can call a game. Karen McKenzie, SSN Network. Let us know, ladies and gentlemen. We're at the point now where we can obviously call the contest, but we'd like to hear from you. You can reach us. Even if you're watching this on tape delay, we'd love to get an email from you. We'll give you a shout-out at our next contest, which will be a week from today. And you can reach us at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. As you see, Irving knocked down 2 for 2 from the foul line, 78 for the Lancers, 32 for the Warriors, 5:50 left in the contest.
Lee, Aaron pass there. Another LaRock steal, or she picks up the loose ball anyways and takes it hard to the bucket, powered up like you talked about earlier, JK. Off the window and good.
Well, we're quite pleased with Jessica's performance here, especially in this fourth quarter. And I do want to give a shout-out. Her high school coach, Andy Kiss, one of the top coaches in the province, and his team competes consistently for the provincial championship, and they'll be hosting the Quad A championships next year in Windsor. Andy is actually here watching Jocelyn play, and he's been a guest in our SSN booth as well as on Cogeco Cable. So Andy, I'm sure, is quite proud of Jocelyn's work.
As he should be, no question. Lancers reel in another Warrior miss. Another rebound for Peklova. LaRock has it now. Just looks like she has more confidence out on the floor every time she touches the basketball. Deuce on the way there for Morgan Jean. Rebound Tilly. Still with it now, Tilly.
Well, we have two of the starters have their warm-up jerseys on. The other has been retaped, and that would be Langlois. I don't expect to see her. And we may see Tessa Williams, perhaps. Gordon will get a few more minutes, but I think what you're seeing on the floor, and if we look at it, can be a little nod to the future in the
Absolutely.
Sense of Jocelyn LaRock and Amber Irving, so that's nice to see them play. Peklova has another year. Jean will not be back, nor will Angus.
Rebound corralled by Irvine. Sorry. Peklova has it baseline.
Go help her. She's picked up her dribble.
Angus gets it now. Warriors might have gotten away with a little push. Hard move by Angus.
Wow.
Leaning in there, flipping it uprighty.
Well, when you come from Steel Town, you take it to the tin hard. Wow.
I guess
nice
you do.
Work for the Hamilton native. She was bumped, pushed, rattled,
she
and
sure
rolled
was.
It in. And there's the sub, as you see Jessica Gordon coming into the game, and Peklova going to the bench. There's Ray Lindprince, the big dog, giving her a big hand and a pat on the backside. So this team is well in front and doing a nice job of supporting each other here in this lopsided victory.
81-32, 4:25 left here in the fourth. Jean, nice little spin move there. Forces her, it's amazing.
Really nice move.
Jean, I mean, she's not the quickest player in the league by far, but she does what she needs to with the ball. She's
crafty.
Deceptive, and she knows how to use her body to shield players off. She's diminutive, as you talked about earlier, JK, but still can score around the rim.
Well, the Lancers are on a long-time winning streak here. They've yet to lose at home. They lost one game to the Toronto Varsity Blue, who came in here and beat them with a depleted lineup. The Lancers had no excuse.
Yep.
You got to defend in your home court with what you're dealt with. And Lancers have been, as we said, on quite the streak since January 22nd. They defeated Brock. They knocked them off 91-67 on the 28th. They knocked off Lakehead and the 29th. Both of those were comfortable wins for the Lancers. And then Guelph, Laurier, McMaster, and now Waterloo falling to the Lancers, really living up to their number two billing in the nation.
Just waiting for Regina to slip up so we can get back in that number one spot.
You got it.
out of bounds, last touched by the Lancers. Give it back to the Warriors. 3:59 left here in the fourth.
Not a misquote, ladies and gentlemen. The Lancers are up 50 at 82-37 with just under 4 minutes to play.
I put the line at 40 before the game today, so
Did you bet the over or the under, though?
No, I put it at 40. So yeah, I was betting the under, I guess.
Yeah,
so
I thought you were high, and I was going to bet the over, but I was too afraid to bet. We live in a town full of casinos, and I won't put any money down. That's my money.
Angus has it. Gets a screen from Gordon.
She's going
to
go right to her.
Nice roll, right to the rim off
the
front.
Finish. Pekova did that same move earlier. You got to use the backboard. The backboard is your friend. It's a lost art.
Yep. Well, and it eliminates the sort of trying to gauge the distance issue that you might have. You can just throw it off the window. You'd have to. It's tougher to miss it off the window that way, no question about it.
And here's the other sub that we thought may happen, and this is just Carissa. A fatigue factor. Morgan Jean has played since the beginning of this quarter and the end of the third quarter, so she just needs to catch her wind, and Carissa Williams comes in. Carissa, of course, is from Amherstburg and played for the Amherst Generals, long-standing double-A champion at the provincial level and a great athlete.
I'm interested to see, J.K., in this lineup, who they're going to put at the one, and it is LaRocque.
Yeah, and this is a good chance for Jocelyn to go back to her more natural position, as you saw Lee throw it in the basket for the Warriors, as Braithwaite gets a chance to come back in as well for Coach Slip.
The Warriors are in the penalty. LaRocque draws the foul there. So she'll step to the line for free throws. You know, even in just that short moment, though, you did see that sort of a she definitely showed a bit of poise there, getting pressured there in the backcourt, and rather than shy away from it, she just went straight into the defender, realizing she had her out of position.
Had the advantage. Interesting work by Coach Vallée, still coaching here with just over three left in the contest. Called the team over during the timeout. Normally, that's a job for the seniors, which are your captains. Coaches on the floor will meet behind the shooter. Vallée, recognizing that she did not have a senior out there, and wanted to bring her girls in just to have a quick chat, and actually gave a little bit of stern comment to Jessica Gordon, and I think it had more to do with her defensive positioning than anything else.
Braithwaite now has it for the Warriors. 2:56 left to play here in this one.
Got away with a travel.
Ooh, I was just about to say that. Very Sorry. Close. Braithwaite off the window pulls down that errant shot. Angus to inbound. Warriors now in full court, man-to-man. Angus breaks the pressure. Gets it now to LaRocque. Lancers will work their offense. Cross now, top side. LaRocque gets it back. Gordon posting hard. Wanted the ball there. Irvine said, I don't think so. I'll just drain this from three. Lancers push the lead back to 50. 86-36.
I just want everybody to know that would be her first three-pointer of the year. She's shooting 100% from three-point range.
That shot, another one that was
I mean, that was her first attempt at a three.
Waterloo pulling down the offensive boards. We're going to get another Waterloo foul on the rebound. Angus came down with it, and we're going to get a call going against Laura Burnett. Her fourth foul now. 1:57 left to play here in the top half of our doubleheader. Men will tip off 20 minutes or so after this one's done. First free throws off. Second one now on the way. That one's through. Burnett, inside look. Aaron pass there, looking for Lougheed inside. LaRocque comes up with it. Gets it to Williams. Cutting through is LaRocque right back. Nice give and go there. Williams to LaRocque.
Points to LaRocque. Looking at double figures here. Buck 30 left. Plenty of time to get that. That's one of the benchmarks of scoring, getting your double figure points.
Oh, nice turnaround there by Jacobs. Minute 28 left here. See if we can get LaRocque.
Jump hook from the baseline. Nice work by Jacobs. Hit it.
Oh, three-pointer now.
Oh, a little long.
Was an open look. Lance just
skip it to her.
Chased down that rebound. Looked inside for Gordon.
Jocelyn should inbounds. They should go. Oh, no, going to give it to Angus. This should be Gordon ball. If she screens across for Angus as Irving. Oh, no, goes right to her. Nice work by Irving.
Tried to go off the window there, fading away.
Yeah,
she tried it that time. Battling for that rebound. Braithwaite comes out with it.
Last minute of play. Last minute.
89-38, as we mentioned earlier. This one was long in the books. Oh, that might have been a travel, too, but nice move there. Once she righted herself from Mackenzie Laheed.
Laheed from Owen Sound. Played for Owen Sound High School. Freshman for Coach Slip. And nice little power move by her there. Hanging on the victory drum.
LaRocque at the top. She's going to flip it up righty off the window. Under 30 seconds to play. Long lead pass available for them. Williams got back to in time to thwart that opportunity. Had the pass come on time, though, would have been a layup.
They're going to hold it. Coach Valle is telling them, just hold it. Although we said that the other day, and on Saturday, you could see Irving kind of went right to the basket. But Clova hit the long three at the end of the game.
Lancers maintaining possession, almost turned it over. Under 5 seconds to play.
Good show of sportsmanship. Didn't need that shot. Lancers lead and win by 49.
Could have had an extra second or two. Put it back on the clock. Everybody agrees the game is over. So at the end of this one, Lancers win it easily here at the St. Denis Center, 89-40. Any closing thoughts with respect to this game, JK?
Well, as expected, and the Lancers now go on the road, and we'll have a chance to continue this streak. But we've got a great contest coming up afterwards as the Lancers will take on the visiting Waterloo Warrior men's team now. So don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to be right back here in about 20 minutes' time.
That's right. You've been listening to CIS Basketball on SSNCanada.ca.